Hey guys, MJ here. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel if you are a subscriber. In today's video, we are going to talk about Bowie and books. Are you ready? Let's go. Today would have been David Bowie's 75th birthday. It's an amazing number, and the reason why I chose to read 75 books this year. So you might be saying to yourself, what is the connection between Bowie and books? Well, it is a well-known fact that David Bowie loved reading. He was a huge reader, and in 2013, he posted on his Facebook page, his 100 favorite books. So I'm gonna put a link in the description box below where you can check out the full list. It's very unique. It could be a little daunting, but it's just a very eclectic list, I would say. There's a little bit of poetry, there's a little bit of humor, there's a little bit of drama, there's a little bit of sci-fi, there's just a little bit of everything. And if you are a reader that doesn't really read the mainstream things, you would be really interested in this list. Another connection between Bowie and books is that he was on one of the famous read posters that was put out by the American Library Association. I actually remember this poster from back in the day, which was way, way, way long ago. And I believe this was the Sirius Moonlight phase, possibly. It was discontinued, and in 2016, get that glare off your face, David. In 2016, it was reissued, and my hubby got me a copy for my birthday because it's all I wanted. I just wanted it. I want to hang it up and just revel in my love for Bowie and books. And in this poster, he is reading The Idiot. That's what he's holding in his hand right there. I do believe this poster may still be available on the American Library Association website. I would highly suggest checking it out if you're interested in it. Ran about, I think, $20 to $25. Took a while to get here, but it's just, if you're a Bowie fan like me and you're a book lover like me, it's perfect. So we're gonna do a little bit of a story time right now. Hang in there because we're gonna talk about books in a little bit. But my first experience with Bowie was on PBS. I used to watch PBS as a child and I loved it. I loved the movies, Sesame Street, the science shows, 3-2-1 Contact, all that good stuff, The Electric Company. If you remember The Electric Company, leave me a comment down below. In between movies and shows, believe it or not, they would show music videos. And they would show the Beatles, they would show the Rolling Stones, and they would show David Bowie. And I remember seeing the Ashes to Ashes video and just being like, what is this? As well as Major Tom. I was just fascinated by it. And then, I think when I was younger before I started watching the videos, I remember hearing about Ziggy Stardust, and I remember there being a news story on like CBS News or something like that, that Ziggy Stardust has left us. I remember going to my mom and saying, Mom, he left, he's never coming back. And she's like, what are you talking about? And I said, Ziggy Stardust, he was an alien, he came down here and he was doing concerts and blah blah blah. I had no clue that it was an alter ego for David Bowie. But I was gutted when I found out that Ziggy went back to Mars. And you know, looking back at it now, it's kind of funny, but also looking back at it now, I see how Bowie has been in my life in numerous different ways. You know, starting with, you know, the whole Ziggy thing. I remember being in grade school, they showed the movie, the concert movie, and I begged my mom to take me and she wouldn't do it. And I was like, oh, darn it. So I had to wait till later in life to see it. And, you know, the videos on PBS, I mean, the Major Tom video is just, I mean, it's good. The Ashes to Ashes one is good too. I'm like, who is this guy dressed like a clown that's a mime? They also showed, I believe they showed the fashion video too, which is just, It's just amazing. I actually watched the fashion video last night. I don't know what to say. It's fantastic. If you've never gone to the David Bowie official YouTube channel, please do so. All of his music videos are on there. There's a number of interviews. They are doing David Bowie 360 now, which is an audio experience. They're playing around with the music and the arrangements, and it's supposed to give you this whole 360 experience when you're listening with headphones. Be sure to check that out as well. But so Bowie's been in my life quite a while, but we haven't been book buds probably since 2010, 2011, when I found out that he just loved reading. Now, when Bowie passed, a little while after, his son Duncan, who is a fabulous director, if you've never seen the movie Moon, you need to. It's a fantastic science fiction. Love it, absolutely love it. Check it out, it may be on Netflix, I'm not sure. But he wanted to start, he talked about his dad's love of reading and he wanted to start a book club on Twitter. And it lasted for about 2 months, maybe. And then I think his family grew and he's like, don't have time for it, can't do it, et cetera, et cetera. But I jumped on the bandwagon and the first book that we read was Peter Ackroyd's Hawksmoor. Now, I think I got this on eBay from the UK at a relatively decent price. This book is a trip. Completely freaked me out. So in Hawksmoor, there's two different plot lines. Almost time travel, parallel universes. There's murders that are happening at churches. There's an 18th century architect and there's a 20th century detective that have parallel lives. And the story jumps from life from time period to time period. So there's a little bit of that. And when we go back to the 18th century, the language is reflected in that. And it's funny because there's actually one or two lines I remember when reading this and I'm like, that's a Bowie lyric. And it was kind of cool when I saw that. So I don't know, I'm pretty sure David may have been inspired by that, but I was like, oh, interesting. So yeah, if you get a chance and you want to get freaked out and maybe want to go to church because there is some graphic stuff in here, Hawksmoor may be for you if you're a fan of horror or mystery or I don't know if you would call this historical fiction. Maybe you would call it historical fiction. But if you're looking for something completely obscure, Hawksmoor may be for you. Second book that we read was James Baldwin, The Fire Next Time. If you are a human being living on planet Earth and never read this, you should read it. You will gain a different perspective. I got really angry when I was reading it, just because of what was happening in the world at that time. I respect his writing. James Baldwin is just phenomenal, and I understand why Bowie put it on his list. So it should be required reading for every human on planet Earth. But it's fantastic. If you've never read it, I highly recommend that you pick it up. Next, we started Cocoon by Spike Milligan. I bought it, never finished it. Duncan closed down the reading group and you know it just kind of sat on my shelf. So I think this year I'm gonna give it a go. The Daily Mail states that it pops with the erratic brilliance of a careless match in a box of fireworks. Who wouldn't like that? So this is another one of Bowie's favorite books on the top 100 list. And if you're looking for something to read about Bowie, I highly recommend Rob Sheffield's On Bowie. This was, I believe it came out after his passing. I'm almost positive. Let me just check. Yes, the first chapter is The Night Bowie Died. So it's a fresh release upon his passing. Rob is a very talented music reporter. He's an author. I think he wrote a book about Duran Duran as well. Another one of my favorite bands. But it's short, it is brave. It talks about the connection that Bowie made with a lot of us. If you're a creative, If you thought, you know, you weren't in the in crowd and you liked art and you liked music and you just kind of didn't fit in and you knew you were unique, you know, Bowie was the lighthouse. Bowie was the one that you went to, and it resonates in this book. It translates really, really well. I'm not gonna share with you my experience when Bowie died. I'm gonna save that for another time. Another fantastic little book is Bowie Pocket Wisdom. It's basically just a small book and has random quotes made by David Bowie. So sometimes what I'll do is I'll just go like this, stop here and see what it says. I'm always amazed that people take what I say seriously. I don't even take what I am seriously. And that was in GQ on July 5th of 2012. Fantastic little thing if you just want to have it on your shelf. If you want to just go to it for a little bit of inspiration, wisdom, anything like that. Pocket Bowie Wisdom, Inspirational Words from a Rock Legend. And it's by Hardy Grant Books. So bowie75 is a real thing. There is a huge concert that is going to be online. His YouTube page is using the logo bowie75. I think there's two pop-up stores, one in London and one in New York, which isn't far from where he lived. Yeah, so there's a lot going on. Sirius XM, I believe it's channel 104. They're bringing back the Bowie channel, I believe, until the 18th, the 11th, something like that. It's gonna be here for a couple days, but I believe it's channel 104. I will post that channel number in the description box as well in case you are a Sirius XM subscriber. And of course I couldn't do this video without wearing a Bowie shirt. And this is David Bowie, Aladdin Sane, 1973. Not original, this is just one of those, you know, pop culture shirts that when you're out walking around in a mall, you see it and you're like, ooh, gotta get that. So I treat David's birthday as a day of celebration. Listen to his music, dance, watch Labyrinth. I actually have the original cassette. This is a cassette from Labyrinth from when I bought it back in the day. Labyrinth is on Netflix. If you don't know what I'm talking about, watch it. It is really good. The soundtrack is really good. David plays an amazing role. It's a fairy tale. I think it's a fairy tale. And they put it on last month. And I'm sure they're gonna have it for a little while. So if you've never seen Labyrinth, or if your children have never seen Labyrinth, I guess maybe age 10 and up, I'd recommend, check it out. Also remember, like, subscribe, comment down below. Let me know, are you a fan of David Bowie? Were you following him? Did his life impact you in any way? I'd be interested in knowing. I know there's a ton of us out there, and music is something that brings people together. So let's make this a positive one. From me, MJ, and David, goodbye for now.